weird to do a review without Jenna, but we've been reading some very different comics and wanted to do more reviews, so we figured we would do some reviews separately sometimes. The Fix is brought to you by Llamas. Just kidding. Created by Nick Spencer and Steve Lieber, The Fix is honestly one of the funniest comics on the shelves right now. What I can tell you is The Fix is more about two crooks named Roy and Mac, who happen to be cops, than crooked cops. I think that's the best way of putting it. The Fix is a farce in every sense of the word. It's absurd, it's obscene, and literally everything in between that. There's a lot of dialogue and narration, which makes it feel like a very perfectly paced crime comedy. And Nick Spencer does so well in setting up and delivering some really crude humor. This is a comic where it's completely evident that the artist and writer really get each other. Steve Lieber is very consistent in terms of his art and his lines. It's so great, and it's even though it's consistent, it's not boring or monotonous. Even when there's not much action going on and it's a lot of dialogue. I have to show you this fashion and all of its tackiness and all of its glory, because it's really a very fitting detail that Steve Lieber put in there for the character Mac. Ryan Hill's colors always seem quite neutral. I would borderline them on the sepia tone Instagram filter color palette as well. But if I were to give Los Angeles, where this comic takes place, a color palette, it would definitely be what Ryan Hill chose. Plot takes precedence over character in this comic, but I feel like that's very typical of a farce. And crooked cop stories are basically as old as the Bible. But like I said earlier, this is definitely a story about crooks who happen to be cops and not crooked cops. So the plot feels fresh, it feels new, and it's just hilarious. I was even left with a oh hell no moment at the end of issue 5, which left me really stoked to continue reading this series. One thing that I appreciate about this comic that I don't think I would appreciate in any other series is that characterization is done extremely quickly, like literally within one page of panels, and that's it. You get it. You get who they are. So you have Roy, who is the narrator of the story, and then you have Mac, who is his gung-ho sidekick, who literally will do anything, I feel like. Then there's Donovan, who completely adds to an extra level of sleaze to this series. And then you have Josh, who is the most ironic mobster possible. And you really need to read this series so you know what I'm talking about. I really love and enjoy the storytelling in this comic, because aside from being hilarious, you can do so much with when everybody is just morally corrupt. Like, literally everyone in the story is morally corrupt. There are so many plot twists you can take with that, and it's perfect, because I really don't think that you can get bored. I don't think that Nick Spencer will run out of ridiculous ideas to continue to throw at us. So with that, I feel like this series can continue to progress, and there's literally nothing at this point right now, having read 1 through 6, that I feel like I would change or improve. Nick Spencer and Steve Lieber are an amazing team together. With that said, even if you only read superhero comics, I highly suggest that you add this to your pull list. And I am going to rate this an 8 out of 8, because I really do like it. This is an amazing read. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe to Alchemist, and also we have Alchemist Gold, which is our random channel for all of our random videos. And don't forget to like us on Instagram. Jenna uses Snapchat, but I do a lot of Instagram stories, so you can follow her personally on Snapchat and me personally on Instagram. But thanks, and we'll see you later. Let's start a fire!